Hello students, welcome to the digital signal processing course. Today we are going to discuss the topic that is IIR filters. So this IIR filter, it means that it is infinite, then impulse and response. So this is how these three terms constitute IIR filters. Now to start the discussion for IIR filter, let's see the concepts of the filter, how exactly it is aligned with the help of the analog filter. So why the analog filter is called as an analog one? The basic reason is it is designed based on the components like resistor, capacitor and inductor. Now the next filter type is nothing but the digital filter. So when we say it is the digital filter, obviously it has to deal up with the difference equation. So when it is dealing up with the difference equation, this difference equation can be implemented with the help of programming languages, let's say the C language or even the assembly level language. These are the two languages which are used to implement the difference equation for solving the critical parameters of the digital filter. Even the coefficients of the filter can also be calculated. So all these complex operations can be made simple with the help of the different programming languages. So for this entire purposes, as well as we can say for filter characteristics determination also, we can use these two languages along with the modern languages. Now the next point which we can discuss for this filter designing, that is nothing but the types of the filter. So when we type this particular filters, it can be distinguished in FIR filter, that is finite impulse response, as well as the IIR filter, that is infinite impulse response filter. Now let's see first of all what is IIR filter, because this entire unit is based on the IIR filter. So before proceeding to this particular topic, let's have some of the advantages of digital filter over the analog filter. So for discussing this point, let's have the very first advantage. The first advantage is nothing but nowadays we are quite familiar with the VLSI technology. So what is VLSI technology? It is very large scale integration. So when we say that it is the VLSI technology, it means that the normal size of the component is made. So when the component size is quite larger, it can be reduced to a smaller size with the help of the VLSI technology. So the same kind of technique can be used over here. So this is the first advantage we can say, that by using the VLSI technology, the hardware size can be reduced further. Similarly, the second advantage, that these are the portable, so obviously these digital filters will be the portable one. Next, it is highly flexible. Fourth advantage which we can mention, that it is nothing but no variation with environment. Means as we can say, in case of the analog filter, like RLC component are highly depending on the environment, variation on the environment. But in case of the digital filter, variation is not possible with respect to the environment changes. So that is why it is quite useful. Next point is nothing but the data saving. So in case of digital filter, as there is a provision of additional memory to save the data, if unfiltered data we want to save at any location, that can be saved because the memory is interfaced in most of the cases of the digital filters. Next point that we can mention is nothing but the in almost all the cases without the actual hardware replacement, one may go for only the software changes. So that can be simply upgraded to have the changes, relative changes. Next point which we can say that it is nothing but the linear phase response. So digital filters do possesses this kind of characteristic, that is nothing but the linear phase response. So based on all these advantages, one may proceed for designing the digital filters. And obviously it is nothing but the digital IR filter. Now to go for the disadvantages of this filter, so while going for the disadvantages, one may see the contrast side of all these advantages also, like the design time for this one. Let's say if I write here the disadvantages, so these are the disadvantages. So the first disadvantage which we can mention is nothing but the design time for this particular filter. It is very long one, so long design time, that is the disadvantage. Similarly, the accuracy of the filter, that is depending on the word length used to encode. So accuracy dependency, it means that if we increase the number of bits to encode, it will be having the more accuracy, but if we use less number of bits, so obviously it is giving the less number of accuracy. So all these are depending on the speed of ADC. So obviously the third parameter will be nothing but the speed limitation, because it is depending on the ADC as well as the DAC. So their conversion from analog to digital or digital to analog, this should be faster if someone expect the more accurate result. Next point which we can just point out over here, like let's say the disadvantage with respect to the software, means whatever the software one may want to go for the upgradation, if it is costly, then this could be the disadvantage, so we cannot go for the upgradation. Similarly, other disadvantage one may say that, let's say if someone go for the VLSI technology, now the frequency dependency over here, if it is for the less or the low frequency component, then obviously for the low frequency component, high value of error addition will be possible. As we can say that the seismic signals are the low frequency signals, even the biomedical applications are also dealing up with the low frequency signals, so they are having this kind of provision that there may be the possibility of lot of interference into the actual signal. Now let's see the next point, that is when we want to go for the IR filters to be designed. So for the design of IR filters, we can go for designing it with the help of the analog filter. Now the natural question may come in your mind that when we are designing the digital filter, why there is a need of analog filters, because these are taken as a base to design the digital filter. So there are certain reasons, like the first reason is nothing but the analog filters are readily available. So these are readily available. Second, one may go for it is quite easier that if you know the properties of analog filters, then the digital filter will become quite easy to implement. So implementation is easy. This is what the second advantage. Now based on these two aspects, there are few methods by which one can design the IR filter. So these methods are, first one is nothing but the approximation of derivative. So approximation of derivative, this is what the first method. Second is nothing but the impulse invariance, this is what the second method. And the third method is nothing but the bilinear transformation. This is also called as a BLT method. So in the next lecture we will see how to proceed for the these different methods to design the IR filters. So thank you everyone. Thank you very much.